my wife Mary and I sing and write music together, and we thought, well, let's put a batch of songs together and get out and play them.
I'm the lead singer, I guess, and then write some of the music as well, and then play tambourine every once in a while, which is fun.
Usually we'll play just because it's easier as a duo at many of the wineries and breweries in Lakes Country, Minnesota. We really like the drums, the lights, the drama of a live show. So every once in a while we try to wrangle some friends together and get them to Battle Lake, Minnesota to come rehearse and play a full band show. My mom and dad had me audition for like the local community college in Fergus Falls. That was my first time getting into the music and dance thing. My best buddy lived right here, and you know, when we turned, you know, eighth grade or something, we'd meet in the woods and we kind of taught each other guitar on his older brother's guitar. And so that's when it really started to, I don't know, sink its teeth in.
I grew up in the suburbs of the Twin Cities. My mom was a piano teacher, and my dad's a pastor, so I grew up in the parsonage. It's like the church house. So I grew up singing in choir, and I learned classically instead of like in a band playing chords or learning by ear. And now, being in a rock and roll band, I feel like it's just been a lot of fun. It's definitely more loose. Dan and I have been playing together. Well, out and about, it's only been about 5 months. We are based out of right here, Battle Lake, Minnesota. We moved here a little over 2 years ago. We were trying so hard to think of the name, which is part, one of the hardest parts for a band, and a song that he wrote kind of stuck out, and we just liked the Blue Red Roses. That was the title of the song.
Drive by and see a sign, it's like, oh, that'd be a good band name. Oh, that's a good band, you know, and they all. So that song was just laying around, and Mary liked the name Blue Red Roses.
Thought it would stick, and that's what we chose.
It's like, yeah, let's do it. And then we have a theme song, too.
Dan and I write the music. So we write some together and some separately. So the music is about, I don't know, everything, our life, and sometimes it's just random stuff, just a catchy phrase, and then we kind of go with the theme of that phrase.
I always want to say, it's so funny.
Everyone writes music, and everyone has music in them in life that I feel like it is kind of connects everybody, and it's in everybody, and there's a rhythm to life.
And I feel like every song is different. You know, some stuff is about past experiences or loves, and some of it is about the present, and some of it is honestly about nothing. It's just kind of like a catchy tune. I think the most common way that it happens would be like a phrase kind of comes to mind, it's like, oh, that's so catchy, or that's a good lyric.
Mary, I entrust Mary more with the lyrics because I don't focus on the lyrics as much. I've always been more of that melody and the rhythm. I don't think too much about it, but once I need an actual story in place, I'll ask Mary to come and help me with some lyrics.
And from there, a theme will arise, and usually the phrase and a melody will come at the same time, and that's kind of like a hook, you know. And once there's a hook, then the rest of it is easier, I guess.
The music has never let go of me. I feel like I've tried to let go of it a few times and try to focus on something else, but I always just want to keep doing it. More than anything, I think I like just the songwriting aspect, writing the song and then putting it together and kind of producing it, and then being able to play it.
And they're literally, they're made like, I mean, like, right down the road from tenure. Yeah. I mean, they're like in the same, it's like in the same neighborhood.
Same neighborhood.
The show tonight is our second time playing as a full band. It's so much fun to play with drums and guitars and piano. Dan and I usually play out as just a duo, which is fun too, but you definitely don't have as much high energy. So tonight will definitely be high energy, some dancing, just a good old rock and roll show.
People come and walk in the door at a Blue Red Roses show, they'll get kind of just this, a blast of some raw energy. A little off the cuff, maybe some spontaneity to the show.
And it's kind of like you get to go into a character and just let loose, and you're there to help everybody have a good time. And I love music, and people love music, humans love music.
We think if we're out with a full band, electrified, lights on, we just want to have a good time. I like it a lot. It's a good way to spend time with each other. It almost kind of feels like a date every time, you know. Let's go to this brewery and play 3 hours.
And now to be able to do that as my living is super awesome. I never thought that would be possible, I guess, but it's been great. It's been really fun.
Postcards is made possible by the Minnesota Arts and Cultural Heritage Fund and the citizens of Minnesota. Additional support provided by Margaret A. Cargill Philanthropies, Mark and Margaret Yackel-Juline on behalf of Shalom Hill Farms, a retreat and conference center in a prairie setting near Windom, Minnesota, on the web at shalomhillfarm.org. Alexandria, Minnesota, a year-round destination with hundreds of lakes, trails, and attractions for memorable vacations and events. More information at explorealex.com. The Lake Region Arts Council's Arts Calendar, an arts and cultural heritage-funded digital calendar showcasing upcoming art events and opportunities for artists in West Central Minnesota. On the web at lrac4calendar.org. Playing today's new music plus your favorite hits, 96.7 Cram. Online at 96.7cram.com.